So, are you looking to buy your first house and you don't understand the steps that need to be taken to actually get there? Well, I'm basically going to break down what I've been doing and I've been able to help these people right here, this person right here, and this person right here basically get the same results that you're looking for. And I'm going to show you step by step by step by step on how to get to where you actually want to be. So, you already know what time it is. Let's get right into it. So when it comes to buying a home, it's a process. And I always talk about having the end in mind and what you really want. So if you're currently renting right now, what you need to do is think about 12 months from now, I'm gonna be in a house. But basically what we're gonna do is reverse engineer that goal and basically break down the steps that we need to do to actually get to that goal, which is purchasing our first home. And if you want those results, you basically gotta think about where you really wanna live, where you wanna be at, and how to actually get there. So first step you wanna do is, what I done was I went to Zillow.com and basically put in new construction homes and find out the area I wanted to live and actually drive around the places I want to be. So first thing you want to do is go find out where you actually want to live at, where you want to be, and how you're going to actually get there. We're going to basically break that part down. So I challenge you to go on Zillow.com right now and just look up all the places that are available right now for you to actually live at 12 months from now, because it's going to be a new construction home and it's going to actually take time to actually build that home. So it's okay to actually start looking right now because you want to be obsessed. And once you find a place you want to be at, what I've done is actually I put it on my phone. I put it on my mirror. I did everything. I actually go visit the place every single week, every single month to actually see a place I want to be at. I was currently renting. And I actually wanted to be in a home because my job, I mean, what I wanted to do with that home, I actually wanted to rent it out eventually because I'm in the military. So what I did was actually found a home and I knew that in due time, I'm actually going to actually rent this house out. So it has to be a new construction home because I know that people like new things and like I know people love new stuff. So all my idea was I get a new construction home, I have this person rent it out and have everything they want. A washer and dryer is new. Fresh paint, the carpet is clean, new furniture. I mean, the fridge is nice, everything is nice. So the goal is for you is whatever you want, what kind of house do you want? Do you want a two-story house? Do you want a pool? Do you want a two-car garage? What do you really want? What do your house, what kind of house do you want? Do you want to live in a condo? Do you want to live in a townhome, three-story? What do you really want? And once you identify what you really want, like I said, go on Zillow.com and identify what kind of area you want to live in. So that's my challenge for you first. Now, after you find out what you really want, and after you figure out what you want, we're gonna basically break this down into 12 months. So if you're currently renting right now and you have 6 to 12 months on that lease, we're gonna break that down to actually get to your goal. So step number one is identify what you want. You find out what you really wanted, the house. Now what you wanna do is look at your credit report, right? So I challenge you to go talk to a realtor, a loan officer, and have them pull your credit report. Okay, it might not be in the best interest, but what the loan officer is gonna tell you is, you gotta get this removed, you gotta get this removed, you need to pay down this, you gotta do this. They're gonna tell you all the steps you need to do to actually qualify for the home. So it will actually work for you to actually get that home. So what you wanna do is go talk to a loan officer, go talk to a realtor, go talk to whoever you need to talk to actually get that credit report pulled. And so he or she can actually break down what you actually need to do to actually qualify for that home. So once you do that, what's gonna happen is they're gonna tell you, you either need a 620 or 640 to either qualify for the house. So depending on where you at, if you're at a 5-something, you know what you gotta do. You gotta remove those collections off your credit report. You have to actually pay down that balance if you have a credit card. You gotta add some credit history on your credit report. So one of the steps you need to do is first identify what's on your credit report. And I always talk about setting up the credit bureaus. So what you wanna do is grab this secret letter right here. It's free. Once you download it, you'll be able to add the different type of accounts onto this letter to actually set the credit bureaus up. So once you set the credit bureaus up, it's much easier for them to, it's much easier to get the results that you're looking for and get those deletion. So remove those collections off your credit report. If you have collections, you gotta add some history on your credit report, right? And you gotta pay down your balance because you wanna be below 10%. A lot of people say 30%, but it's really 10%, and you'll see the maximum results. And if you can pay it down to zero, it's gonna be even better. But to add age on your credit report, you wanna do Rent Reporters, or Rental Karma. And if you're renting right now, you can add all that history on your credit report right now. So what you want to do is go to rentreporters.com and rental karma. That's what I did. I added both, and I had two trade lines on my credit report to help me boost up my credit. I was living in that apartment for 2 years, and I added all 2 years on my credit report. And you can do the same thing if you've been on that. If you've been at that apartment, just add that history. You just got to pay a little extra fee for actually to report that. But it's worth it. So you're gonna see a major increase in your credit score. Next, what you need to do is after you added that, you pay down your balance. After you clean up your credit report, you want to add a trade line to get a higher credit score, right? Because depending on where you're at, depending on how much stuff you have on your credit report, I can't judge. But if you have 3 to 4 accounts, it'll be good. But if you don't, you would just want to start adding, talk to a relative that has good credit and add a credit card on their credit, add on a credit card on your credit report, right? Become an authorized user. You don't need no credit card from them. All you just need is that history. And you're going to add that on, that's going to be added on your credit report, and it's going to see a dramatic increase in your credit score. So, but you want to make sure all your stuff is cleaned up first before you add that, because you can't make it pretty with negative stuff on your credit report. So what you got to do is clean that up first, and then you add that on, and then you'll see your credit score increase. So once you do that, now your credit score is above a 700, right? And now you're looking good. So now you're going to go back to the loan officer and say, yo, I'm qualified. So what's going to happen is he or she's going to run that report. They're going to say, you're good. You qualify for this home. You pre-qualify for this home. Now the next steps is you're going to ask for them bank statements. They're going to ask for your work history. They're going to ask for all this, your tax statements, right? So what you want to do is make sure you have all your ducks in a row to actually qualify for this home. So make sure you've been working for the last 2 years. Make sure you don't have no overdraft fees when it comes to looking at your bank. Make sure your inquiries, your address is all cleaned up, because they're gonna ask for all this information. If you have a lot of inquiries on your credit report, they're gonna ask why you applied for here. Why did you apply there? Why did you apply there? Why did you move here? And why did you move that? I'm telling you, they go, it's a headache. But if you have everything cleaned up, it'll be a smooth process. On my second home I purchased, it only took 14 days to actually close on the house, because I had all the ducks in a row. I didn't have nothing like I had when I had the first house. I didn't have no overdraft fees. I didn't have no whole bunch of inquiries on my credit report. I didn't have no late payments. I had none of that. Everything was cleaned up. So that's what you got to do to actually get to where you actually want to be. And once you get all that stuff cleaned up, you're going to be able to close on that home. But of course, it's going to take time to clean up your credit report. And once you get everything, it took me about 4 to 5 months to actually clean up everything on my credit report to go back to that home. And what's going to be happening is you're building history, you're building and you're adding credit. So it's going to take a little time, but it's okay, because you're doing what you need to do to clean up your credit report. Also, you're actually still renting, so it's still going to take time, because you really don't want to break the lease and pay extra money. So after you clean up your credit report, you go to the actual agent, the loan officer, get pre-qualified, and then within 30 to 45 days, you'll be able to close on that home, depending on if it's available, because it's a new construction home. So I hope these tips helped you out, and if you have any questions, just drop them in the comments. I really appreciate you for watching this. Hit the like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the other side of purchasing that home and good credit. See y'all.